In my last lecture, I have shown what is ER diagram and the basic concept of ER diagram. Now, let us see some examples how to design a database using ER diagram using the top-down approach model. Suppose I am considering one example of an employee database. In a company, the assumptions that we have taken employees are working in a department. Employees are managed by a manager of a department. Who is also an employee. Next, employee has dependent, as if the company wants to give the medical treatment facilities to all the dependent of that employee, that case we have to keep the records of all the employees. Employee works in a project, and the projects are handled by each department. Now, these are the conditions and the assumptions have been given. After the, it's based upon you that what type of assumptions you are taking. Based on this, your ER diagram will change, or the cardinality ratio or the participation constraints will get changed. Now, whatever the available assumptions we have, based on this, we have to identify the number of entities. What are the possible entities should be? So, one entity may be the employee entity. Other entity, as employees are working in a department, department may be another entity. What else? As the employees are working in a project which is controlled by the department, that case project may be another entity. And employee has some dependent. That means the employee family member. So, these are the possible entities. After that, if we find any other entities, then we will keep it adding. Now, we have to find out the relationship based on the assumption between those entities. Now, what should be the relationship between employee and department? We can identify that employee works in a department. This one is dependent. Okay. And what should be the relationship between the employee and dependent? Employee has dependent. And the relationship between department and project is department has projects, several projects. Now, already I told that some of the employees are there who are the manager of a department. And each department should have only one manager, and those managers are managing the other employees also. So I can say that employee manages department. As well as the those employees are managing the other employees also. So can I draw another one? Employee manages employee. Now these are the possible relationship between the entities based on our available informations. Now after that we have to find out the cardinality ratio, that means the degree of participation of each entity in the relationship. Now what should be the cardinality ratio between employee and department? As one employee will works in only one department, but each department may have multiple numbers of employees. So this cardinality should be m is to 1 and one employee is managing one department and each department is managed by only one employee, that case the cardinality ratio between employee manages department, this relationship is 1 is to 1. Now employee manages employee, who will manage? The manager. And in this side it should be employee. So one manager may manage multiple numbers of employee. So in this case the cardinality ratio will be 1 is to m. Now what should be the cardinality ratio between employee has dependent? And note it that dependent is a weak entity. Why? Because the dependent entity is solely dependent on the employee entity. It doesn't have any primary key of its own. So employee has dependent, in this case it must be 1 is to m. And department has projects, one department that we have to consider that whether each department has many projects, it's okay. Now is this project is controlled by multiple number of department? If it is so, that it will be m is to n relationship, and if it is not, that means each project is handled by only one department, that case it will be 1 is to m. Now all the cardinality ratio we have given. Now we have to find out the participation constraint. That means the employee works in a department, that case I have to check that whether all the employees apart from working in a department, is the employees are doing any other jobs. If it is not that case, in this case the participation constraint will be fully participation. But in case of department also I have to check that apart from managing the employees, is the department is doing any other job? Yes, the department is also managing the projects also. So that case from the department side it should be partial participation. Now in case of employee manages department, in this case also same thing, employee are managing the department, apart from managing the department they are working in the department also. So in this case this participation is partial participation. And the same case also happens in case of department. Department, apart from managing the employee, they are managing the project also. So this one is also partial participation. So participation of this part is over, we have checked it. Now let us check the participation between employee and dependent. Dependent is only dependent on the employee. So from the dependent side, as it is a weak entity, so it's a partial participation. But from employee side, the employee is involved in any other relationship apart from this dependent. So from the employee side, it should be partial participation. Now let us check from the department and project relationship. In this case, department, apart from the project relationship, they are related with the employees also. So from the department side it should be partial participation, but in the project side, as the project is controlled by only department, it is not related with any other relationship. It may happen that if I write and write another relationship, that is employee works in a project, that case it will be partial participation. I forgot to mention this relationship, that is employee works in a project. So that case one employee is working, multiple number of employee is working in a single project. So that case the project is also a partial, is in a partial relationship. Okay, so this is the entire entity relationship diagram that we have drawn. The cardinality ratio is given, as well as the participation constant is also given, now the next part is to find out the schema design. So based on this we have to find out that how many tables should be possible. So the thumb rule is that the number of entity should be included in the number of, as a number of tables. Apart from this, we have to check that is there any ternary relationship is there. If ternary relationship is there, that case it will be considered as a separate table, as well as if the relation if there is there any M-to-N relationship is there. If it is there, that case it will also be considered as a separate table. Now, as there is no ternary relationship, as well as there is no M to N relationship, many to many relationship is there. So I can say that the employee, department, project and dependent, these four must be the table. So let us draw the employee table first. Now what should be the attribute of this employee table? One may be EMP ID, then EMP name, DOB, manager ID, the project the employee is working, project ID, department ID. So this may be the important attributes. Apart from this, is there any other relevant attributes are there, we will put it. Next one is department. Now it should have a department ID. Department name, department is controlling some project, so that project ID, department is controlled by manager, so manager ID, I forgot to write the dependent name also in this case, so dependent name. Now next is the project. Now it must be identified by project ID, project name, project location, controlled by department, so department ID, okay. Now next is the dependent. It must have dependent. In this case I cannot consider any dependent ID, because dependent ID cannot be a primary key. So what we consider, that the dependent name, and each of the dependent name must be associated with one employee ID, and age, and relationship with the employee. So these are my four tables. Now we have to identify the primary key and the foreign key of each table. So obviously employee ID must be the primary key, department ID must be the primary key in department table, project ID must be the primary key in case of project table. Now what should be the primary key in dependent? As it is a weak entity, it does not have any single primary key of its own. So dependent entity will be fully dependent on the employee entity. So dependent name cannot be a primary key, but a composite key of dependent name and employee ID can be a primary key. Now how to connect each of the entity, each of the tables. Now in case of department, as each of the department has one department ID and also department ID, and this department ID is also present in employee table. So this department ID is the foreign key and it will be connected with the department ID of the department. Now similarly, a department has one project ID because department is running the projects. So this project ID will be connected will work as a primary key, foreign key, and will connect with the project ID of the project. Now in case of project, the department ID will act as a foreign key and it will be connected with the department ID of department. Similarly, this dependent name and EMP ID will act as a foreign key and it must be connected with the employee ID of the primary key. This project ID of employee table will act as a foreign key and it will connect with the project ID of the project table. And there will be one self-referential integrity constant will be also there. What is self-referential integrity constant? A foreign key will refer a primary key of its own table. That means this manager ID must be a foreign key of this employee table, which will refer the employee ID, because this manager is also an employee also. So this is all about my schema design. Hope you understand. In the next lecture I will show you with another example.